Bye-bye, DDR4!
Hello, DDR5!
This is MLM, don't go anywhere! Finally, the JEDEC Solid State Technology Association, the organization that is responsible for developing and setting standards for open memory standards, have officially announced the specs for DDR5 SDRAM. This will be a blueprint for memory makers to follow as the industry says goodbye to DDR4. So, what is new? Number 1. The chip density on DDR5 has been increased to 64 gigabit from 16 gigabit on the DDR4. So what does this mean to you leh? For a standard unbuffered DIMM that we use in our desktops, this means that it can theoretically reach 128 gigabyte per DIMM, just one stick of RAM. Of course, we'll need to wait until further down the road when the manufacturers catch up to reach that crazy number. But we might see 16GB be the most common DIMM capacity as compared to 8GB today, which will be a good improvement. Number 2. The max data rate has increased from 3.2 gigabit per second to 6.4 gigabit per second, which means faster memory for you and me. JEDEC is expecting launch speeds of around 4.8 gigabit per second, and don't forget, we have already broken DDR4's maximum of 3.2 gigabit per second. Don't be surprised if we see SK Hynix releasing a crazy 8400 MHz RAM later in the decade. Number 3. DDR5 features on-chip voltage regulation. This promises better voltage tolerance on improved DRAM yields as well as reduced power consumption.
Yes!
The official rated voltage has gone down from 1.2 voltage to 1.1 voltage. Faster RAM that takes less power? TMB can never surprise us with a nuclear-sized electricity bill anymore. We are unsure when DDR5 will arrive to our desktops, but an insider told Gamers Nexus that AMD only intend to support DDR5 in their premium desktops in 2022. So I guess it is only safe to throw away our DDR4 in 2022. If you are an Android user, listen up. A leaked copy of device configuration guide for Android 11 has shown something rather interesting. Looks like any devices that wants to run Android 11 huh, must have more than 2GB of RAM. If you cannot upgrade to anything more than that, then you have to run the OS on Android Go. What is Android Go? Android Go is basically Android but for lower-end Android phone. This is to ensure that users will not go through a compromised experience due to hardware limitations. According to sources, the changes will only start rolling out towards the end of this year, which is very soon. However, phones that launch on prior Android versions on 2GB RAM will be exempted from this requirement. Anyway, the leak also revealed that any devices with only up to 512 MB of RAM will not be accessible to GMS and anymore, Google Mobile Services. It looks like they want to stop people from buying lower-end phones. You think everyone can afford high-end, man? If you're somebody who uses camera to take awesome pictures and videos instead of your smartphones, chances are you have heard of Sony RX100. With more people staying at home because of the pandemic, content creation and also social media usage has been at all-time high. Well, Sony probably recognized the opportunity, which is why they modified their RX100. The ZV-1 is Sony's first compact camera to feature a side-opening vari-angle touchscreen display. So for you TikTok users out there, there's one thing that's even more gangtao, okay? You can shoot videos in portrait mode. With a 20 megapixel sensor and no aperture ring around the lens, the ZV-1 can handle automatic focus and exposure. It records videos up to 4K at 30 frames per second and HD at up to 120 frames per second. HLG and HDR are also supported along with built-in optical and electronic stabilization. When you're vlogging, the camera will even sharpen your eyes and face thanks to its real-time eye autofocus and face priority auto exposure features. And if you're shooting a product, this camera can even auto-focus onto the product when you bring it up to the lens. So easy! You don't need to go reach out to the lens and, you know, focus to your product. As for the audio, the camera has a 3-capsule microphone built in and a slot-on windshield for minimal wind noise. The ZV-1 is now available for purchase on Sony Malaysia's website for only 3,399 ringgit. What do you guys think? Is it a cheap buy? Now, we all know that GTA 6 is in early stages of development. Meanwhile, on Reddit, GTA fans have put together a concept map that looks very unlikely but also kind of likely to happen. So why don't you guys take a look? Reddit user MegaHurst posted a GTA 6 concept map that combines various cities and locations of previous GTA games into one epic open world. Another user also commented that this will give more purpose to boats and planes instead of, you know, just causing mayhem, and also road trips will be more interesting as you have more stops in between. Personally, I hate big maps lah, and this kind of game is not really for me, because can you imagine the pain you have to face while you travel across just to get to your destination? Unless there's such thing as teleporting, that wouldn't mind. What I hope to see in GTA 6 are bigger heist missions and more thrilling missions, because that's what GTA is all about, right? Oh, and more apartment options too, because I want to be a mermaid and I want to live in my fancy mermaid seashell room, just like Animal Crossing. We have all used our parents' credit cards before. Secretly or not, then when you keep it to yourself lah. Whether or not we truly use, we still won't have the balls to spend 1,000 ringgit in a single swipe, right? But there's this young boy who has bigger balls than us, and he has caused quite a stir as his parents went on Reddit to ask for help after finding out how much your son has spent on Twitch. This boy spent a total of $20,000 on Twitch subscriptions and donations to an NBA player and 3 very popular Twitch streamers. And all this without his parents' concern until the bill arrived. Yikes. Do you guys think that the parents will get back the money less, since this is not really a fraud, right? And what would you guys do if your kid does this to you? So that's all we have today for our MLM. And if you're interested in our comments reading session, you can head over to our Facebook page and keep an eye out on our Thursday live streams. So head on to our page if you haven't already, and like our page if you haven't already. I'll see you guys in the next MLM. Bye! This promises better on chip. This promises better voltage. Tolerance. Help me.